Happy weekend, NIO fam. Before I get into why I think Elon Musk in this most recent earnings call for Tesla might have accidentally been pumping or hyping NIO with its energy play, and I'm going to pull up the transcript and read something directly from what he actually said in the call. Before I get to that, I want to tell you a story, because a few years ago, there was a NIO user in Chengdu, China, and his name is Nick. And shout out, Nick, if you see this video. Nick, I remember talking with Nick, and this was at a time, and he's in a city of over 20 million people, massive, huge city. And in those cities, a lot of people don't have access to charging infrastructure in their own home. Well, he did. And so during this natural disaster that they were having, I can't remember if it was a drought or what it was, but during this time, he was able to charge his vehicle at home overnight. And then in the morning, he could take his vehicle to the swap station. He could swap his full battery into the swap station, and someone else who needed a full battery could take the battery, and he could basically leave with a depleted battery, go home, charge it, and return the next day. In sort of an acknowledgement, or you know, maybe this was even something that NIO was promoting at the time, they awarded him NIO points, which he could then go to NIO Life with, and through their e-commerce, he could actually buy NIO products. This was amazing to hear. And this is several years ago. Now, the reason I want to share this is I don't think a lot of people realize the level or the extent of not just the technology and the innovative aspect that this company has and brings, but I also don't think people realize so much of what has happened and been going on behind the scenes for years now with this company. And so I'm just going to enjoy down the road when it does become acknowledged and recognized and more mainstream. But I think we've got time. I don't know what that time frame is. I do think that we're going to see a pivot point in the near term, in the next year or two probably. And I'm not just talking about China and Europe, but beyond. And I don't know what countries are going to welcome it first or fastest. That's part of the unknown, and I think it'll be fun to track. But now let's get to the Elon comments from the most recent earnings call. This is one of the things that he did. And he typically, I was really curious to listen out on this earnings call, because normally he spends about 10 minutes at the beginning of the call hyping something, whether it's, you know, autonomous driving and or Optimus or whatever. And in this one, he actually spent, I think, even more time than normal hyping things. But this is one of the things he said about energy storage. And I just kind of perked up when I heard it, because he said, energy storage is a big deal and will become really super important, will become incredibly important in the future. And it is something that enables for greater energy output to the grid than is currently possible, because the vast majority of the grid has no energy storage capability. So they have to design the power plants to or for very high peaks, and assuming that there's no energy storage. So energy storage, power plants. All right, that's the theme. Just sit back and enjoy. I'm going to share all of these links in the description so you can check them out and take things further on your own as per the research that you want to. But what I've done is I've arranged these in a timeline. And the reason I wanted to start with that story was not just to share a pretty cool experience that Nick had and I was grateful that he shared with me, but that was several years ago. All right. So some of these things have been going on. NIO's been testing things out for years. Now, this is an article from July in 2023, and I've highlighted the piece that I want to get into. I'm not going to go too far in depth in any of these so that this video won't get too lengthy. And again, that way people can just kind of research as to, you know, their own preference. But here's what I want to point out. NIO launched the 20 kilowatt V2G vehicle to grid charging pile, which not only provides fast charging, but also allows bi-directional energy flow, enabling electric vehicles to absorb electricity from the grid during low demand periods and release electricity to the grid during peak hours. This interaction between the vehicle and the grid helps with peak shaving and frequency regulation. And then it goes on to say that NIO is going to partner with a national park to create the world's first V2G self-circulation power replenishment system, which will be operational in August. We're going to go to that next. Now, this is a video I've shared several times before, and yet it still doesn't even have 800 views, which tells me that the vast majority of the globe still has no idea NIO is doing things like this. But this is that earlier referenced collaboration. NIO collaborated with four parties to create the world's first photovoltaic self-consumption system with V2G vehicle-to-grid charger. And so then Now we've got this article from February in 2024, why China's EV ambitions need virtual power plants. And so then if we go down here, I've highlighted one piece to talk about, and that is NIO, a leading Chinese EV company, is transforming its own charging networks. Last month, 10 NIO charging stations opened in Shanghai that allow vehicles to feed energy back into the grid. The company also has over 2,000, and now it's over 3,000, battery swapping stations across the country. These are ideal energy storage resources for the VPP virtual power plant network. Some of them have already been connected to VPP pilot programs in eastern China, the company said in July of 2023. One of the key obstacles to adoption of VPPs is getting people to sign up to participate, but there's a compelling reward on offer: money. If the reverse charging infrastructure grows larger, millions of Chinese EV owners could make a little income by charging at the right times and selling electricity at others. This just goes beyond what anyone's talking about or thinking about at this stage. I love that NIO is years ahead with this. This is still in February of 2024, but there are a couple of things. I'm not going to read the whole article, but there are two pieces I wanted to point out. As a new type of power coordination and management system, the VPP, again, the virtual power plant, is critical for achieving flexible bidirectional control of the power system. Enabled by communications technologies, IoT, and software algorithms, VPPs are able to aggregate, coordinate, and optimize charging and swapping facilities, solar panels, energy storage systems, and microgrids distributed in different locations to realize optimal resource utilization. We go down a little bit further. NIO's power swap stations are the first intelligent microgrid distributed battery swapping system in China, capable of participating in effective grid regulation through order forecast and real-time assessment of charging loads. In 2019, again, we're nodding to years ago. NIO's been doing things for so long and people aren't even aware of it. In 2019, NIO already helped with the load shifting in Shanghai by coordinating its power swap stations and home chargers connected to the NIO power cloud. And it goes on to talk about other stuff I'm not going to highlight. I'm not going to read it all. You can do that on your own if you want. We're going to keep moving forward though, because now in March of 2024, NIO starts operating first photovoltaic energy storage charging discharging integrated station for expressway. So this is, you know, if you want to see the clean parks as sort of the pilot program, the test product, now they're expanding it. And where's the point that I wanted? Here it is. NIO's journey into vehicle grid integration, highlighted by its active participation in off-peak battery swapping and orderly V2G charging projects, underscores its innovative approach to energy management. Now, there's one other thing I want to point out. I've noticed this, that in different parts of the country within China, NIO's partnering with the local, whether it's the municipalities, the governments, basically, at some level. And one of the things that they are getting in return is investment dollars from those entities, from those municipalities or those governments in different regions of the country. Super smart. And again, a nod to William Lee, Mr. EQ, for his brilliance, his emotional quotient, and recognizing there are unconventional ways that NIO can bring in partners and raise capital without having to do at the market offerings. I love that. I love that he has picked up and is doing some of these things as NIO grows. This is a reference to NIO with their swap stations, the Generation 4, now operational. This is from June of 2024. And this is the piece, and it's again a nod to, you know, the different areas and the things that NIO is doing. So this is the first station jointly established by NIO and Zhongnan Energy after signing the strategic partnership agreement on March 22nd. Going forward, they will deploy more all-in-one stations, meaning the charging and swapping stations also capable of solar power generation and energy storage. In Anhui province, from where the network will radiate to the Yangtze River Delta and even the entire country. NIO, with just over 3,100 actually, and the number is growing, power swap stations, they have a goal of 5,000 in 2025. I think it's important they get there. I think this infrastructure build out has much more potential revenue return for NIO than anyone is going to realize for a while. And I'm okay with that, but I wanted to highlight it and share it with the folks who I think also are doing some research and appreciate some of these things early on. This is August 2024 NIO hosting Power Up. And one of the things I want to point out here is they talk about or reference a lot of their partners. They do not share all the partners in here, but it is nice to have these reference points if you do want to do some of your own digging and research and that sort of thing. So I did want to share this and also kind of keep in line with the time frame as I'm moving along here. How about September of 2024? NIO Power revolutionizes EV mobility and energy storage in Europe. Folks, this is NIO moving outside of China with some of these things that they are now proving out within China are working. And so I'm just wondering what different regions of the globe are going to adopt and welcome this. The potential is just unknown because it could work, I think, in most places, you know, across the world, but I don't know if there will be governments, entities, regions, areas that won't welcome it. I'm just not sure, but Europe is adopting some of this. So here we've got power swap technology, a new chapter in EV charging. NIO's power swap technology, launched in Europe in 2022, offers an innovative alternative to traditional plug-in charging. Equipped with over 1,600 patented technologies, the power swap stations enable fully automated battery swaps in just 3 minutes, making it faster than conventional refueling. Each station, and these are, they're talking about generation three, holds up to 21 batteries and can complete up to 408 swaps a day, providing a convenient, cost-effective solution for EV drivers across Europe. And fun fact, and kind of an update on this, the Gen 4, I believe, hold 23 batteries. I think they could do 480 swaps a day. And the, what was the other? As far as the swap time, I know that, and shout out, China Driven, Will, has seen, and I think has even recorded, Onvo swapping in 2.5 minutes. The level of innovation that NIO is bringing is not recognized. I absolutely believe that so many folks are sleeping on this company and making a lot of mistakes in not doing more research to figure out what a global giant in the making this company is. I absolutely believe it. I've called it a unicorn. We've never seen a company like this before. Unicorn meaning there's only one, and I haven't seen anything like it. It just continues to blow me away. And frankly, it took me a couple of hours to gather kind of my thoughts together, get all the research tidbits and everything kind of aligned to do this video. And then of course the recording part. But what is amazing is every time that I start digging in and doing more research, I'm like, man, I could just keep going. There's so much more that I know I haven't uncovered. There's so much more that this company is doing than anyone knows, maybe outside of William Lee, Mr. EQ, as I like to call him. It's going to be a lot of fun to see just how disruptive and how profitable things like the energy storage and all of the value add propositions that NIO has, not just for the user, for the consumer, from, you know, the price point being, you know, lessened by battery as a service and the optionality of renting the battery versus purchasing. But if you can utilize, you know, Valet swap or have the cargo swap itself, you know, things that other companies are talking about doing, but clearly haven't been able to do, NIO's better positioned already to do them. I love it. I love where they're sitting up. Stock price, that's a whole other topic. We'll talk about that in another video because in this one, I just wanted to talk about how I thought it was a little telling, ironic, and kind of fun that Elon was accidentally pumping NIO and had no clue. I don't think he had any idea that he was doing it. Now, if he comes out and announces a partnership with NIO and that they're going to be doing, you know, swappable models, which I've said before, I think would be smart for them to do. I think Tesla and BYD, I'll say it again now, I think they will lose market share if they don't pivot. And it's not just because of NIO. It's because of some of the other major players within the Chinese automotive market that are going ahead and partnering and coming out with their own swappable models. This, I think, is going to be a pivot point into the future, not just from the energy place, you know, side of it, but those companies also will benefit from recognizing and getting involved and getting a piece of that business. NIO is happy to partner with other folks. Again, this is one of the things that I think is brilliant about the guy running the company, but I'm just gushing now. This is embarrassing. So let me stop, cut this thing off. Have a great weekend. I'll be back with more content before you know it. See y'all again very soon.